Hey, Watermark friends and family, we have an important update today. In this video, we want to share our heart for reopening indoor services. After lots of prayer and processing at the elder level, the staff level, we think that there are a few parameters that permit us to do so. The first thing is a decreasing in the wave of COVID cases. The second thing is a legal permission. From the very beginning, we've said that as a church, we're not interested in being cowboys or cowgirls, you know, just fighting for our rights and freedoms. Not that, it's just that we want to be consistent in accordance with Romans 13, the laws of the land. And then finally, and most convincingly for me, maintaining the unity and accord of our church. And we believe with the volunteer elder board and the staff-driven conversation we had, that we're going to be able to do that. So I just want to share a brief story. When we tried to do this about a month or two ago for the succession services, and it was out of process, I learned something. I want to humbly submit that to you. I thought I could just move a process through really, really quick on my own, and I learned a lesson. This time around, we were given time, we were given process, we were given prayers, and consensus was reached. And you should just take confidence and hope in that you have people on the volunteer level and staff level who are totally working together. We're not working or leading in isolation. So I want to tell you now, get into some of the practicals, what I'm so excited about. Again, not my rights or my freedoms. We give those over to Jesus at baptism, by the way. That's not what this is about. It's not we're having a celebration because our rights and freedoms as Americans are restored. No. I'm excited for this opportunity because I think it creates more space for fellowship for COVID vulnerable peoples to return to church. And that's really who I want to talk to in this video. A lot of you guys who are running back to church, not a problem. You're happy, that's great, but you were kind of already coming. I want to talk to you, our church family members and friends who have been attending online and at home, and probably for really good reason. I'm excited because the back deck is still going to be a service. The back deck's going to be opened with 100% masked attendance. It's going to have the screen and audio. It's even going to have a campus pastor present. And they're outdoors, socially distant, so that you can take one more baby step in getting back into in-person services yourself. And so whether that offer sounds attractive to you or not, I don't know, but we just want to express our heart for those who have been really vulnerable during this time, and we want to help you as best we can take the baby steps back into fellowship. And so will there be a screen still? Yes, it's going to be a screen. Is that different from watching at home? We certainly think so, because you're in person, you're on campus, there are other people, you're getting used to the motions of what it means to be back in an in-person fellowship. And I just want to say, if you're not convinced and that's not ready for you yet, fine, awesome. We love you just where you're at, that's okay. But the one thing we do want to keep leaning in and encouraging you on is to pray. Mm-hmm. Just pray. Just speak to God like we know you already are. Ask God, when is it permissible for you and yours, your family, your loved ones? When is it appropriate? When is it okay? And then do whatever he says. Not what I say, not what we think or say, our opinion, but what he's saying. Mm-hmm. And there's one final thing. There's one final thing in this video. You made it to the end. Congratulations. We need help.
Yes, we need you guys to volunteer. We are so excited to be back indoors. But that means because we've actually grown over COVID, which is super amazing and wonderful, we are going back into two services to also create more space for people to socially distance. Right. In order to facilitate all of our needs for two services inside, we need about 20 kids volunteers and 20 guest experience volunteers. Just because of numbers and the way that we're allowing children to come back in, we have to keep the capacities of the classrooms low, which mm-hmm. means we have to have more classrooms open. And because of that, we need more volunteers to come in and be in all of those classes. And then guest experience as well, we have multiple ways for people to come in. We will have people on the deck, people inside. So we just want to make sure that we cover all of our bases and that everybody here feels safe and welcome. And so we could really use your help. So contact me if you want to be a kids volunteer.
Yeah, that's right. I'm so glad you mentioned this practical step. Uh-huh. Just send an email. And if you don't have Melissa's email, you can just go to watermarkoc.com/contact. Kids team. Just put kids team in there and we will follow up with you immediately. We'll get you a speedy background check so you can be approved to work with kids right away. But guys, this whole thing, gathering indoor, online, in person, outside, wherever it is about serving one another. Mm-hmm. That's why the church exists, is to serve one another, to love one another, to grow with each other and with our God. And we're so excited to go indoors, and we want to serve you in that way, but we're going to have to serve one another if we're going to make this happen. So even you parents of young kids, I'm one of them. When I'm not preaching, I'm going to be in a classroom. I'm making that commitment right now on the record with you. So if you are able and willing to come in person on any level, consider joining a team with kids or guest experience. They're all just service ministries, how to love and serve on others well. So thanks for watching this. We'll see you this weekend, online, outdoor, and indoor, 9 and 10:30. Thanks, you guys.